your butt back to the house right now. I'll make you very sorry. You can't do this. I won't let you. Do you hear me? I'm not letting you go. Well, I'm letting you go. You're mine. Enough playing around, baby. Come on. You know what I want.
Your Uncle Jake was a fine man. Deeply missed.
Hello? Yeah, yes I am. Really? When? Yeah, yes I understand. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Is something wrong?
Uncle Jake. No, everything's fine. I'm gonna be leaving for a while.
Why? What's going on?
Deb, I don't want to talk about it. It's family shit. I don't know when I'm coming back.
Great. Fucking great.
Dad.
Just like that. Bye. Ciao. See you when I get back, maybe.
Deb, I'm sorry you feel this way. I thought we made everything clear.
Everything's clear, all right. Crystal.
Deb, don't take it personally. You know that.
I know. I know. It's been fun. No strings attached, right? Well, tell me where you are one day. And I'll send you a postcard.
Come on, Deb.
Thank you.
Come on.
Jake's nephew?
Yeah, yes I am. Mr.
Vincenzo. Anthony Vincenzo. I'm your closest neighbor, you know, right up that road over there.
Ah, pleased to meet you.
Yeah, likewise. Yeah, so I see you're a painter, an artist.
I'm trying to be.
Ah, there's no harm in trying. You know, I dabble in photography myself.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So listen, when was the last time you were up here?
Oh. When I was 11, I used to come here every summer until then.
How long are you planning on staying at Jake's place?
For a while.
I'm sorry. I guess I should call it your place now, eh? I heard at the funeral that you're Jake's last living relative.
How was the funeral? You know, I would have been there if I could.
It's not really much to say. You know, old Jake didn't have many friends.
It's a damn shame. Drowning. No one should go like that.
That's what they told you, eh? That's what they tell everybody. Well, let me tell you something. Strange things happen around this lake. I mean, real strange.
What do you mean, strange things? You don't think my uncle drowned?
Oh, I'm sure he drowned, all right. You see, you could say that a lot of people drowned around here.
What do you mean?
Well, just that if I was you, I wouldn't stick around too long, you know, and I'd sell the house if I was able.
This is such a bad area. What are you doing here?
Hey, like I said, I'd sell the house if I was able. I'm not able. But I'm careful. Just as you should be. Now you have yourself a nice day there, Mr. Lowry.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, buddy, how's it going? Fine, besides the fact that I'm losing my mind, I feel pretty good.
What is it, David? What can I do for you?
Mr. Vincenzo, who is this woman?
Yeah. You want some breakfast?
Oh, thanks, man.
Nah. You don't have to believe what I'm going to say, and, you know, you probably won't. But I owe it to your Uncle Jake to tell you, and you owe it to yourself to listen.
Okay, man. Go ahead, I'm listening.
All right. You ever hear about the legend of Lady of the Lake? Not the King Arthur one, but our own local legend.
I don't remember.
Well, as the story goes, about 100 years ago or so, there was this young gypsy girl called Vivian. And, you know, according to the legend, she was this powerful witch. And, you know, she would come out here in these woods and camp here with a bunch of carnival performers who come up once every few years to the village. And one day, this knight falls in love with her. Well, I mean, he wasn't a real knight. He was part of the carnival performers. These guys would come up here wearing these big armors and have these big sword fights, you know, just like in medieval times. And you know, people from the village, they loved it. You know, they couldn't get enough of it. Anyways, this guy, you know, he's got the hots for her, right? So, I mean, you know, she doesn't want to give. So what happens, eh? What happens? The guy, he takes the sword, eh? And wham! Yeah, right into this tree.
So he killed her right here?
Yeah. Yeah, and then he took her body, and he went to dump her down on the lake. But they say that she put a curse on the guys in this area. And I mean, since then, you know, there's been all these kinds of weird drownings, you know, when guys have been fishing or swimming. Fuck, at this rate, we're bound to make, you know, the cover of the fucking Inquirer. That's why there's hardly any houses around here. People are superstitious.
Did Jake believe in this legend?
No, not at first. But it seems his sister, your aunt, you know, she was a big believer. And, you know, when she died and Jake inherited the house, we sort of became buddies. And that's when he told me about the legend. But he didn't believe it up until a few months ago.
What happened?
Well, he started telling me that, you know, he was seeing this gypsy in his dreams, on the lake, in the woods, everywhere. You know, he was becoming obsessed with the legend. I told him, I said, listen, Jake, you lay off that sauce and get some rest. But he swore on his grave that, you know, she was real.
Who do you think she really was?
Well, unless you're crazy in the head, you know, you'd think old Jake had picked up some hitchhiker or some fucking whore, you know, who went along with this gypsy thing to, you know, to humor him. And then when she found him dead, she left.
That makes sense, but you don't seem to believe it.
Well, let's just say I seen a lot of shit happen around here. And, you know, sometimes I start thinking that old Jake wasn't so fucking crazy after all. And that maybe there is a curse here that drives people fucking nuts. And not right away. Slowly. One day at a time. That's why if I was you, I'd get the hell away now.
So why don't you?
Because I ain't you, buddy.
Thank you. Come on. Come to Ed. Yes. Vivian! Who do you love, Vivian? Come to Anthony. Come on.
Atta girl. That's it, baby. That's it. You love
me? Why, Anthony, of course.
Good. I love you, too.
Don't you see, eh? Come on, don't you see that she's playing with you? That's what she fucking does. She makes you fall in love with her, and then she torments you, and finally she kills you.
Wait a minute. You know more than you've been telling me. You've seen her, haven't you? You know she's real.
Listen, you might think she's God's gift to man right now, but she's gonna put you through hell. Through more shit than you can handle.
You're lying. I don't know why, but you're lying.
Thank you.
Man, stop! I want to talk to you.
Dead long ago. And what do you see in my future, lovely Vivian? You, perhaps?
Yours is a black heart, Richard. The cold, black heart of a viper. I don't need to look into your hand to see that.
Since I fancy you, I'll take your remarks as playfulness. Mind what you say. I'm not always in such a forgiving mood. Now read my hand. We all know that you are not a charlatan, and your visions ring true. What glories lie in my future?
Go away, Richard.
Do you see the scares you say? Our wedding night?
Don't worry, I will be gentle.
Never. You disgust me. I would rather die than be with one such as you.
Beware your words, Vivian. You will be mine, I promise it. You may be able to see into the future, but I will make my future happen.
Mm-hmm. What have you done to me? I cannot stop thinking about you.
Let me go. Have you gone mad?
For the last time, marry me.
Let me go.
Know the meaning of love. All you know is hate and violence.
If I cannot have your heart, no one will.
I curse you and all those of your kind.
So you finally decided to come back, huh? That's it, baby. Come on. Dance for me. Dance for me like you used to.
Your dough.
Yeah. Hey, baby. close the lights.
You have beauty in your heart. If you want, I can stay with you for a week, but then I will leave you forever, and you must let me go. Do you accept?
I do.
As real as you wish.
Why didn't you come back to me, eh? I would have done anything for you. Anything! But no. No. I wasn't good enough for you, eh? Eh? Well, fuck you, bitch. You fucking slut. You fucking whore. You didn't want me? Well, fuck you! Yeah! Fuck! Yeah!
Are you afraid?
Yeah, of course I'm afraid.
Body lies by your side. See, she is all the Dark One. And soon you will join her long list of victims. Second thoughts, why don't I just kill you right now? Are you up to it, Anthony, old friend?
He loves me not.
Who do you love? Come on. Come to end. Yes. Vivian!
What if you have to go?
Who do you love, Vivian?
Boy!
Come to Anthony. Come on. That a girl. That's it. That's it. Hello?
Why, Anthony?
Dead, you motherfuckers! Say your prayers! I'm coming to get you!
Loves me not. No more petals, this flower's dead.
How can you be here?
I do not really know.
Sometimes I think I'm going crazy. But you know what? I don't care. I've never been happier since I've been here with you. What's wrong?
I wish I could be at peace, but my soul is sad and cold. I bring you joy now, but soon it will turn black.
Doesn't matter. You're here now. I'll never love anybody else.
You cannot love me. What you see is merely a shadow of my true self, a mirrored image. If you knew me as I was, as a real woman, maybe.
Yes, yes. I'd want to know you. Everything about you.
Even though I'll have to leave soon, forever.
I don't care.
There is a way.
Tell me.
It is dangerous.
I don't care. Just tell me what I have to do. I'll do it.
I will show you. This is where the magic is strongest. Do you want to see my world?
Yes.
Then dance with me. David, there's something I must do. Everything. Everything has a price. Love, vengeance, even your presence here. and I must pay for it.
No, you don't have to pay.
It is unavoidable. Do not worry. I will be back.
Vivian, wait.
Friend?
You.
Now, you have two choices. I could kill you, and you die like the cow which you are. Or we duel, and you die like a man.
Take it.
Oh, no.
David, we must go back.
Why? Why now?
Time moves differently here. Only a few moments have passed since we left. You must hold your promise to me and let me leave. Every minute we delay, the danger grows.
Danger? What danger? From Richard?
No. It is I you must fear. When the moon rises, I will no longer be in control of my actions.
How do we get back?
You're already there. David? It's almost time. I must leave you. Stay, I will kill you, as I've killed many others.
Maybe we can find a way to break the curse.
No, David. I do not belong in this world. The curse is slowly filling my heart with hate for you, where only love should be.
Will I ever see you again?
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Anthony. Died last summer, committed suicide. He drowned himself.
But Vivian, I'm not dead.
I know. But I am.
Fuck this.
I'm leaving now. I know you can't come back to my world. I just want to tell you that I'm willing to join yours.
Thank you.